Hello students, today we'll be talking about cereals. So as you all know, in the Indian diet, cereals form the majority of the food which is eaten. All right, whether be it North India or South India or East India or West India, I mean to say all parts of India, cereals form one of the major components of the diet, whether it is in the form of wheat, whether it is in the form of rice, or it is in the form of various different millets like ragi, like jowar, like bajra. So cereals are consumed a lot in the diets. And what are cereals basically? They are the food which are forming the bulk of the diet which is consumed by Indians. All right, not just Indians, all over the world, people eat a lot of bread. People eat breakfast cereals. You eat oats, you'll eat cornflakes, you eat muesli. So basically cereals are all which are eaten in high quantity, in great amounts, by all the people living in the world. And these cereals basically, they contain a good amount of carbohydrate. Why? Because carbohydrate is, you know, it's a good source of energy. And apart from carbohydrate, it contains proteins, but different types of cereals have different amount of protein and carbohydrate content. The principal cereals that we generally use in the diets are wheat, maize, okay, sorghum, the millets, the rice, barley, oats, and rye. Okay, so cereals, when we talk about cereals, they belong to the monocotyledonous family, which you can say like this, monocots. Okay, and the grass family, they belong to the grass family, which is known as the graminae. Okay, that is the graminae. So when we talk about cereals, we talk about the structure of the cereals as well. All right, the grains are formed from the flowers, as you know, and they are enclosed in a pair of leaves which is known as the lemma and pallia. Okay, so they are enclosed in a pair of leaves which are called lemma and pallia. After fertilization, when they are fertilized, the ovary and the ovule start to develop into the grain. Okay, so you know the process of fertilization. So after the process of fertilization, the grain starts to develop, and the lemma and the pallia are shed off during the threshing of the wheat, rye, maize, sorghum, and barley. So, and this leaves the naked seed. And these naked grains of seeds are called the caryopsis. So these naked grains, you can give them the name of caryopsis. They are called caryopsis. So this happens in the threshing of wheat, rye, maize, sorghum, and barley. Okay, but in certain other wheat products or cereal products like your rice, like in oats, the layers are still there, and they are basically these grains are still covered by the lemma and the pallia. Okay, so naked caryopsis, when we talk about the naked caryopsis, it consists of the coat, which is known as the pericarp. Okay, then the seed is there. Apart from the pericarp, there is a seed. Okay, the seed consists of a seed coat. It consists of the germ and the endosperm. So when we talk about the seed, it has the outermost seed coat, then it has the germ, and it has the innermost endosperm. All right, seed consists of the seed coat, the germ, and the endosperm. And when they are covered, they have the pallia and the lemma, which were there in rice and oats. And this form the basically husk of the grains. Okay, so next we talk about the composition of the cereal grains. Now, as you can see in this table over here, there are different kinds of cereals, okay? And the amount of moisture, the amount of protein, the amount of mineral, fiber, and carbohydrate is written. So when we talk about bajra, when we talk about barley, when we talk about maize, when we talk about oats, we have different amounts of moisture, protein, fats, minerals, fibers, and carbohydrates which is present in there. So if we talk about the protein content, when we talk about the protein content, the highest amount of protein content, if we can see, is there in the rye. And what is rye basically? Rye, or you can call it triticum cereal, or you can call it cereal, cereal, is basically a hybrid between the normal wheat and the triticum variety. Okay, that is why it is known as triticale. So rye has the highest amount of protein if we talk about the protein content, after which we have the whole before rye we have the protein content of 13.6, which is present in oatmeal. I'm sorry for that. So first in number comes the oatmeal, which has 13.6 grams of protein per 100 grams of the cereal. Okay, after oatmeal comes rye.